BAM!
Mr. Taru, guess what we're going to take a look at today? Well, if you're following my videos and you saw the last post for pre-calculus, you might have an idea. Synthetic division. Okay. Long division is monotonous, and it's easy to lose your place and make sign errors. You always have to check for that little minus sign when you're working out your polynomials as you work your way down. And so if there's ever an opportunity to take a shortcut, why not do it? And that's what synthetic division is. Synthetic division is doable if you are dividing by a binomial in the form of x minus c. So we're about to do an example, and I'm going to do this other remainder theorem with that same example. And with synthetic division, as long as you're dividing by something with a leading coefficient of 1 and the binomial has a degree of 1, you can do your synthetic division to shortcut the problem and not have to go through all the steps of long division. But synthetic, again, only works if your leading coefficient is 1 and the degree of that binomial is 1. Otherwise, you are stuck doing long division. Okay, so synthetic division. Let's do an example. All right, so we are going to divide x plus 1 into 5x cubed plus 6x plus 8. And I've written this in long division format just to, you know, show you the tie-in together. Also, we're going from a third degree to a first degree. If you want to do this properly, whether it's long division or synthetic division, you need to put the zeros in there as placeholders for the exponents so it all lines up in nice columns. And that means that this needs to be rewritten as 5x to the third plus 0x squared plus 6x plus 8. But we're not doing long division. We have a binomial. We have a leading coefficient of 1. We have a degree of 1, or an exponent of 1. And we are dividing by something in the form of a binomial in the form of x minus c. Do you see that minus that's in the form? That means that for this to be x plus 1, it must be x minus a negative 1. So we are going to do synthetic division with negative 1, not positive 1. When you pull these numbers out of these binomials to do synthetic division, you must remember to change the sign. All right, so here's what we got. We've got negative 1. Little square brackets indicate synthetic division. I'm going to write this polynomial out with no x's, just the numbers, just the coefficients. 5, 0, 6, and 8. I'm going to draw a baseline, and unlike division where you're subtracting your way down when you do your all your steps of long division, with synthetic division you are going to be adding. Now here's the process. Bring the first number down. Okay, nothing happened. Whoopee-doo. What you do now is you take the number that's in this red box that I've now made red, if you can see that, and you're going to come through here and you're going to multiply by whatever number is down here. So negative 1 times 5 is negative 5. And then add. 0 minus 5 is negative 5. And then multiply. Negative 1 times negative 5 is positive 5. Bam! Now you're on this line. Add. 6 plus 5 is 11. And now back to your synthetic division. Negative 1 times 11 is going to be negative 11. And now add, and we get negative 3. Well, what the heck does all this mean? It's just a bunch of numbers. Well, when you have a polynomial to the third degree, and you do long division, and you divide by the first degree, you're going to subtract 1 to all the exponents. If you watch my video on long division, you'll notice that pattern. So this is originally 5x cubed right here. Well, now, after dividing by a degree of 1, this is going to become 5x squared. The degree, the exponent of 1 subtracting by 1 for this one. This was 0x squared, now it's negative 5. Your exponents are counting down, still counting down, so negative 5x plus a constant of 11, now you're 3. Remember, original exponents were 3, 2, 1, and a constant. Well, now it's not 3, but 2. It's been reduced by 1. 2, 1, constant. So this must be the remainder. So plus, excuse me, minus, well, you can write that, plus negative 3, the remainder, over what you were dividing by, which was not, well, we synthetically divided with negative 1, but the original binomial was x plus 1. Voila! You get the same answer if you did long division, but that was so much quicker. Oh, I love it. Now, let me give you an example of something called the Remainder Theorem. Remainder Theorem is always in a textbook with your synthetic division. And I'm not going to teach you Remainder Theorem by showing you the Remainder Theorem. I'm actually just going to ask you to do this. F of x equals 5x cubed plus 6x plus 8. Does that sound familiar? It's right there. It's what we divided into. And I want to find out, what is f of negative 1? Does the negative 1 look familiar? The negative 1 is what we did our synthetic division by. So I'm just giving you a polynomial and saying, hey, plug in negative 1. Let's see how bad the maths are if you were to do it by just plugging in the number. You do have to remember, I'm teaching this in front of a camera that I'm putting over the whole internet. So I'm going to pick some numbers that are relatively simple to work out. However, this process that I'm showing you where you just plug in the number, that very often is a very cumbersome process that you would not want to do without the aid of a calculator. But let's see what it looks like anyway. Negative 1 to the third is negative 1 plus 6 times negative 1 plus 8. Negative 1 times 5 is negative 5 plus, well, that's negative. Negative 6 and plus 8. So negative 5 and negative 6 is negative 11. Plus 8, and negative 11 plus 8 is negative 3. Where have I seen that answer before? That was my remainder. So, what does that mean? That means that when I give a function, or when you're given a function, and you say, hey, find f of 10, I can plug it into the function and work it out. Now, negative 1 is a very simple number, and these were all very simple to come up even with, coming up even within my head. But a lot of times, it's very hard to do this, where you just say, here's a function with a lot of high exponents. Go tell me what f of 10 is, or f of 6, or f of 5. Well, what you can do instead is set up synthetic division and do the process with synthetic division. And synthetic division is, let me erase this because I don't really need this for the remainder theorem. I did for the original problem. But with synthetic division, you can say, I want f of negative 1, so you synthetically divide by negative 1. The remainder is the answer you would get from plugging that number into the function. Also note that if I say, what's f of negative 1, I used negative 1. I didn't change the sign. And I think I have one more time. I might change the number here. Oh, yeah. So let's just do that again. Let's say that I want Well, it's probably easier just to rewrite it all. Let's say I want f of 3. Well, that is 5 times 3 cubed plus 6 times 3 plus 8. Let's see if I need to edit this video out because I can't do this in my head. 3 cubed, 3, 9, 27. So 5 times 27 plus 3 times 6 is 18 plus 8. Well, what's 5 times 27? Well, mental math, if you're trying to do mental math, you should be going left to right, not right to left like you do it on your paper. What's 5 times 20? 5 times 20 is 100. And 5 times 7 is 35. So 5 times 27 is 100 plus 35. So 135 plus, well, what's 18 and 8? 18 and 8 is 26. And now what's 135 plus 26? Well, it's 135 plus 20, which is 155. And 155 plus 6 is 161. So we got through that without the aid of a calculator. What would that look like with synthetic division? Well, I'm asked to figure out what f of 3 is. So I'm going to synthetically divide by 3. And 5 for the third degree, 0 for the non-existent second degree, 6 for the first degree, and 8. Let's see if we can do this. Remember, it is addition and multiplication down here. So bring down the 5 and multiply. 3 times 5 is 15. Add on this line. Add. 0 and 15 is 15. Now multiply. 3 times 15, that's 45. And add. That's now 51. Now multiply. 3 times 51. Well, 3 times 50 is 150, and 3 times 1 is 3, so 153. 3 times 51 is 153, and 8 plus 153 is 161. Woo! All right. The synthetic division gave us the same answer as we got when we plugged in the number. That's synthetic division. That is the remainder theorem. Bam! Woo! Thank you very much.